Hello friends, this is Hardik Dholakiya and you are watching my channel Flexible Mathematics. And today's topic is how to convert a non-terminating recurring number into p by q form. So before I start, let me tell you there are two types, that non-terminating non-recurring number and non-terminating recurring number. So what is non-terminating non-recurring number? So here it is.
Actually, the number is non-terminating. Non-terminating means what? Here you can see that the decimal part is not ending here. Means you cannot see and here because it is 3, 8, 5 and so on. It is continued. So this kind of thing is known as non-terminating. After that, non-recurring. Non-recurring means what? You can see here that there is not any particular pattern which is repeated again. Here all the things are different means 2, 3, 7, 4, 9, 4, 7, 3, 8, 5 and so on. So this kind of number cannot be converted into p by q form, means we cannot convert this number into rational number because it is irrational. But the number which are non-terminating but recurring, that can be converted into p by q form. So what is non-terminating recurring number? So here it is. So you can see here in the decimal part, here 347, 347, 347 means same pattern is repeated. So this kind of number is known as non-terminating. Non-terminating why? Because it is non-ending also. But it is recurring, means one particular pattern is followed here. So here you can see that we can write this kind of number by this way. Means we can write 12.347 bar. This bar means this pattern is repeated. So this kind of number can be converted into p by q form. So actually this is a 9th standard topic, but it is also very very useful in some competitive exam related to banking and other sectors. So ordinary method, or you can say traditional method, that is already given in the textbook or digest. But today I will teach you how to convert this kind of number into p by q form very shortly. Okay. So let's take one example and I will tell you how we can convert it into p by q form easily. Let's start. Okay, so I am taking this kind of number. If you can see bar here, means it is recurring. So what is the original form of this number? Actually this number is 5.5. Here bar is on these two numbers, means this pattern is repeated. 6, 6, 6, 6, 6, 6 and so on. So how to convert this number into p by q form? So very easy method is that. First of all, just consider this full number. We are converting it into p by q form, means there will be one numerator and one denominator. So for the numerator, what we have to do? For the numerator, just consider the full number. Just write this full number 5, 5, 6, 6. Just ignore this decimal point and this bar also. Means by ignoring this decimal and bar, just write down the full number. After that, you have to subtract. What to subtract? Just subtract the number which don't have any bar on it. Don't consider this decimal and bar, okay? So here you can see here bar is on these two digits. But that is not any bar on this number and this number. So just write that number here. 5, 5. Now, our work for the numerator is completed. Now for the denominator, what we have to do? For the denominator, we have to consider only the decimal part. I repeat, only decimal part you have to consider. Here decimal part is 5, 6, 6 and bar above it. So, in the decimal part, just write the 9. How many times? Just count that how many numbers have bar on it. Here you can see that there is a two numbers which have bar on it. So write 9 two times. 9 one time and 9 second time. And then after we have to write 0. So how many times 0? First, again consider this decimal part and see that how many number does not have any bar on it. Here you can see there is only one number, means there is only one number, that is 5, which don't have any bar on it. So just write 0 one time. So the next operation is to do the subtraction. If you subtract 5566 minus 55, means if you subtract 55 from 5566, you will get the answer 5511 and downside 990. So we have just converted this kind of non-terminating recurring number into p by q form very easily. So if you do this operation in the calculator, means if you divide 5511 by 990, you will get this answer in your calculator. You can check it. Okay, so let's take another example. So it is 22.45 bar. Means what is the original number? Here the bar is on 45, means this pattern is repeated. So we can write 22.454545 and so on. Now in this case what to do? Same operation. First of all, write the full number ignoring the decimal part and the bar. So we will write 2245. Then after subtract, what to subtract? From the full number, write down the digits which don't have any bar on it. Here you can see that this number and this number don't have any bar on it. So write 22 here. Now downside. For the downside, we have to just consider the decimal part, means this part only. Now in the decimal part, how many numbers have bar on it? Here you can see this 4 and 5 both have bar on it. So we will write 9 two times because there are two digits. So we will write 9 two times. But what about 0? In the decimal part, there is not any number which do not have any bar on it. So there is no need to write 0 downside. So just do the subtraction above side. 2245 minus 22. So we will get 2223
by 99.
So it is a p by q form of this number. You can check in the calculator if you divide 2223 by 99, the answer will be 22.454545 and so on. Okay, so I hope you are understanding. Okay, let's do two more examples. So here it is. It is 0.473 and having bar on all the three digits. So first of all, what is the original number? Actually, it is 0.473473 and so on. So here you can see that is 0 here. So what to do? Same operation, just write down the full number ignoring the decimal part and bar. So just write 0473. Now subtract. What to subtract from the full number? Just write down the digits here which do not have any bar. So here there is only 0 which don't have any bar. So just write down 0 here. So for downside, just consider the decimal part. In the decimal part, how many numbers have bar on it? Here there are 3 digits which are having bar on it. So we will write 9 3 times. 1, 2, and 3. And how many times 0? Can you see any number which don't have any bar in the decimal part? No, there is not any number in the decimal part which don't have any bar on it. So there is no need to write 0. Now it is very easy actually, because 0473, actually it is a 473 minus 0. The answer will be same, means 473. And downside, triple line. So you can check 473 divided by 999. The answer will be 0.473473 and so on. So last but not least, we will take one longer number, or we can say bigger number. Okay, so this number is a little bit bigger.
Okay, but do not worry, it is also very easy.
It is 2.11 and 765 about it. So what is the original number?
Actually, it is a 2.11765765 and so on.
So now how to convert?
Same operation. Just remove the decimal and bar and write the full number.
211765. Now subtraction.
What to subtract? Just see that which digits don't have any bar on it. Here you can see that 2, 1 and 1 don't have any bar on it. Just subtract that 211.
Now for the downside,
just consider there is decimal part.
So this is the decimal part.
In the decimal part, how many numbers have bar on it? Here 1, 2 and 3 numbers have bar on it. So write 9 three times.
1, 2, 3 and 4 zeros.
How many numbers don't have any bar on it? Here you can see that 11 means 1 and 1 don't have any bar on it. So here these are 2 digits. So we will write 0 2 times.
0, 0. Now if we do this subtraction, what answer we will get? We will get 2, 1, 1.
7 minus 2, it will be 5.
6 minus 1, 5 and 5 minus 1, 4 and downside 9 9 9 double 0.
So this way you can solve this kind of non-terminating recurring numbers and you can convert this into p by q form. And I hope this is the easiest method to convert, because in exam you can skip this step.
Okay, so directly you can
do this in the rough work. So I hope you will like this.
I will upload a new video soon related to this topic. So stay tuned and please share and subscribe. Thank you.
Hello friends, if you have any question regarding this topic or any other topic, you can drop your question in the comment box. I will try to answer all your questions.